Here, welcoming you to Madden Ultimate Team. It's the NFL on EA Sports between our visitors and the Chicago Bears. With that, let's get out to venerable Soldier Field in Chicago. Standing by with the call, here are Brandon Godden and Gerald Davis.
Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Godden, and Charles, kickoff moments away. Quickly, what are you watching in this one?
The offensive line for both teams, because both teams have a terrific pass rush. They've got to keep their passers upright. If they have a chance to do that, they can both thrive on offense and move the ball downfield.
And on second down, the offense gets ready to rock. Vic on second down. Just inside the 10, back at the 9. Tahir White in there to bury him for a loss of 11.
But that didn't start to have a good drive. Quite like a big loss on a sack, does it?
Now they're looking at a third and long, and suddenly the momentum shifted to the other side of the football.
And old Mo is a very, very fickle man.
Thing deep, and this is caught right along the sideline. What a job of keeping the toes in bounds there. And a big 32-yard play on third. Working the sideline there. Good route, good catch. First down, and he gets out of bounds.
They have to like the play call because you have to run some guys down the middle of the field to draw some of the defenders away. They can't just let them guard the sideline exclusively. That's how it's going to work. Sidelines and incompletions to use the clock.
And the big play pushes him all the way out to the 40 now for first down. Here's Mahomes, his first throw since coming in. And he's got it. What a catch on the sideline. He got 29 yards that time. And at this stage, down in the second half, looks like they just wanted to find a way to get it in the hands of their playmaker, and they did.
I think you're exactly right. I don't think the coordinator is looking at his play sheet and trying to figure out which play will work well. He's trying to figure out how to get the ball to the playmaker that you just described. Looking down at that sheet, you find people plays, not necessarily X's and O's, and that's exactly what they did there.
And now a first chance for the backup here to throw. He's going to rifle one deep left side. So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect.
Trying to erase that deficit all at once. One big shot. He took it. Unfortunately for him, incomplete.
Ball on the 30 as they come up second and 10. And here comes throw number one for the backup QB. Takes the ball down the field and scores on their opening drive.
Boy, that route is really tough to cover because if they're running it correctly, you think it's really going to be a slant.
Yeah, well, we talk all the time about how it's tough to execute offensively, but you're saying, don't forget, it's tough to cover for the defense, too.
Yeah, the number one thing that you're taught is to not get caught inside or get beat inside. So you guard that a little bit more. So that gives you a little bit more space to operate outside if you start your move initially inside if you're a receiver.
Tucker able to connect on the extra point, and the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Fielded about a yard deep. They will take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. Now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. Now Trubisky on first down. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Deion Sanders. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. And the defense could not have written a much better script than that first drive. Pick six.
The offense never got a chance to really get oiled up there, did they? But the defense, they certainly got in gear. What a big-time play and a great way for them to start.
And now the offense, they've got to turn things around and figure this out because your backs are on the ground real quickly.
Yeah, usually when you're starting the game getting the ball, 0-0 is the only score you're worried about. Now the second time you get it, you're already down a touchdown.
Now Tucker to add the PAT. Tucker with the extra point, and the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. This is Fielding a couple yards deep. And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been if he simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. The Bears offense now getting ready to take over. First drive, they're being aggressive, slinging it around.
Really confident, too, because they're not trying to fool them with running plays, throwing it, and they're being very successful right now.
On second down, it's Dre. And a 52-yard run here, brought down there. It goes as a gain of eight, it moves the chains.
I hope we give enough respect to the big guys up front because they have been getting it done on this drive. The holes have been large and they've been barreling through and picking up first downs.
Time for a break. We'll come back to wrap this one up after this. So the Bears with the football here as we welcome you back. They've got a first and 10 as they search for a late score. Trubisky on first down. He goes underneath the drape. A good cover defensively as they get to him just beyond the 45 after the juke. It's a gain of five on the play, and it'll be a second down. Throwing now is Trubisky. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Quick take down a Hall of Famer, Derek Brooks. And he returns it into enemy territory. Defenses have had their struggles, but they've been good enough to get them this lead and another nice play there to help preserve the lead.
It's been a game of punch counter punch, hasn't it? All throughout. But this time, the big swing was taken and it didn't land. Nice play by them on defense.
That one looks like he'll throw here. Flush to his right. And his first look is incomplete.
Tell us about who's going to run our first down, the offense or the defense. Let's face it, if you've got the ball, 4 yards or more on first down is what you're aiming for. They tried to throw for it there. Nice effort to knock that one away and bring up second down.
Big to throw. They'll rifle this one deep right side. And they went for a big play through the air on second down. Couldn't connect. That's third.
But that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice, getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, he opened up the defense a little bit, loosened them up, and got back on their heels.
And now the first throw for the backup quarterback. He's going to rifle one deep left side. That's going to be caught. And now we're going to get a timeout here called by the defense. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. So defensive timeout, chance to regather, regroup, and get set as we resume action. A good chance now to put this game on ice. This is first and goal. They come out here in the eye. They'll try and run for it with Fournette. And he is in the end zone for a touchdown. A great play there. Taking it in. And this offense takes the ball down the field and scores on their opening drive.
Well, it'd be real easy to say that they are firmly in control right now, but I'm looking at your face and I'm thinking I've got to be careful with that.
Well, it's a two-score game. You're inside of 2 minutes. I think you can breathe relatively easily now.
Yeah, you can, but still, you got to stay vigilant. Can't give up anything cheap and easy. That could put you in some jeopardy.
Tucker able to connect on the extra point, and the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Fielded about a yard deep. And the decision to bring it out will cost him about 5 yards as he'll get this only back to the 20. And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. Turnover. Now can this offense cash in? First and goal. Vic now after the fumble recovery. And his first pass here is going to fall incomplete. George Kittle, the receiver that he was looking for. And that'll bring up second down.
And that's one he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You have to think on early downs like that first down there, he can be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
Now a second down throw for Vic. And he almost intercepted it. They haven't picked a ball off yet. That probably should have been there first. And it's third down now.
Those throwing windows get a lot tighter near the end zone, don't they? And here's the thing. You already probably have 3 points in your hip pocket. You force a throw here and give up an interception, you come away with nothing.
Especially tough in the middle third of the field where he threw that one. Great run. It's good. And they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 10-yard line. A loss of a yard, and it brings up fourth.
This offense bent the defense in their long drive downfield, but once they got within sight of the goal line, the defense went to don't break mode and is stiffened.
Yeah, They'll go with a good play for it. And this doesn't end well at all as they stop him far behind the line to gain. They come up short here on fourth down. And this crowd into it early. Their guys stand tall on the opening drive of the football game. So they were really trying to put the nail in the coffin there already with this lead here in the fourth, but they didn't get it.
Guaranteed, it's not going to be a fun handshake in the postgame, right?
You just know. This is going to be a safety as Trubisky gets swallowed up in the end zone. Well, this defense has been smothering all game long. Why not give them two more points here in the closing minutes?
Well, they've certainly earned it. They're getting the bait of this offensive line for three quarters, and this sack here will just be a little icing on the cake. Well, whatever the relationship was between the special teams and the offense, it's gotten a heck of a lot closer after a return like that. The special teams just keep setting them up. The offense thinks they'll go out there and knock them down.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Vic's going to take a knee, and that should just about do it. Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you start thinking you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
Mm-hmm.